Hello, church. I hope you're doing well this fine Wednesday. I hope your families are doing well. And I can't wait to see you guys again. When I was growing up in my parents' house, I had been known to lose my temper at times. I had been known to let my emotions get the best of me, to let my tongue get the best of me. And this is something that I was known for around my house. And on the most recent memory, probably the one of the last times I lost my temper, my dad finally sat me down and we had a really long conversation. And at the end of this conversation, my dad told me what my quote unquote punishment was that I was about to write a sermon on anger. And not only was I going to write a sermon on anger, he had already called our preacher, who was one of our friends, and arranged it to where that next Sunday night, I was the preacher and I was going to be giving this sermon over anger. And that was quite a punishment. But he guided me into a passage. He walked me into this passage and he sat me down and he said, read this and write your sermon. And you'll be good, son. You just need to think about this. And so I did. That next Sunday night, I gave a sermon over anger. It was one of my first times in the pulpit. And I vividly remember that time. But my sermon touched in James chapter 3. Starting in verse 3, it says, if we put bits into the mouths of horses so that they obey us, we guide the whole of their body. Look at the ships also. Though they are so large and are driven by strong winds, they are guided by a very small rudder. Wherever the will of the pilot directs, so also the tongue is a small member, yet it boasts of great things. How great a forest is set ablaze by such a small fire. And the tongue is a fire, a world of unrighteousness. The tongue is set among our members, staining the whole body, setting on fire the entire course of life, and set on fire by hell. See, the most uncontrollable part of our body, I'm convinced, is our tongue. It's one of those things that, especially if you're like me, you can speak without thinking a lot of times. Or you just don't care what you speak, and so you just say it outright. But especially today, in the midst of what is going on in our society, I've seen people ripping people apart left and right over the smallest things, over their smallest views of what is going on in this particular time. And I'm reminded of this verse every time I see someone being ripped apart. I'm reminded of what the author of James here says about what our tongues are. I'm reminded that we have the ability to bless our Father with our tongues. It says right here in verse 9 that with it we bless our Lord and Father, and with it we curse people who are made in the likeness of God. I'd like to see that hopefully we would be blessing our Father and blessing those that He created, but a lot of times it's not so. So today I want to encourage you to do something. I want to encourage you to check your tongue at the door. I want to encourage all of us, including myself, to check our tongue at the door. This time, especially right now, calls for a tremendous amount of grace to be poured out on everyone and towards everyone. Everyone needs an extra measure of grace because we're all encountering what we're going through differently. And I think this calls for a tremendous amount of grace on all of our parts towards everyone else. So let's be sure that we are pursuing that. Let's be sure that we are checking our tongue at the door before we pursue what's in our mouth to say. I want to encourage you to do so, to not only bless our Father, but also bless those that He has made and that are made in the likeness of Him. I hope you have a blessed day. I hope your families are doing well. And I cannot wait to see you guys again. Have a good day.